In this video, we can discuss about introduction to the hormones, which is an important topic from pharmacology of drugs used in hormone deficiencies and different hormonal disorders. In this, we will discuss the definition of hormone, different glands and its hormones secreted in the body, and we will discuss some general functions, regulation of release and mechanism of actions of different hormones released in our body. Let's start with the definition of hormones. Hormones are substances of intense biological activity which are produced by specific cells which are known as endogenous glands or endocrine glands or ductless glands, and which are secreted directly into the blood circulation, and these are transported through the circulation to act its target cell at different site of the body. So in short, these are intense biological molecules or substances produced by endocrine glands which are secreted to the blood and transported through the blood to act different target cells in the body. Now, what is the function of hormone? In general, hormone will regulate the body function to bring a programmed pattern of life event, and this will help in maintaining homeostasis. So this is the function in general. So each hormones have different action, and all the hormone together will act to get a regulated body function to get or to maintain the homeostasis. Now coming to the glands and hormones which are present in body, there are six glands: pituitary gland, thyroid gland, parathyroid gland, pancreas, adrenal gland and gonads, which are very important. So all these hormones are released, or sorry, all these gland will release different type of hormone. Like anterior pituitary gland will release growth hormone, prolactin, adrenocorticotropic hormone, thyroid stimulating hormone, and gonadotropins like follicular stimulating hormone and luteinizing hormone. And posterior pituitary hormone will release oxytocin and vasopressin, which is also known as antidiuretic hormone. And thyroid gland will release different thyroid hormones like thyroxine, triiodothyronine and calcitonin. And parathyroid glands will release parathormone. And pancreas, especially the islets of Langerhans of pancreas, will release insulin as well as glucagon. And adrenal gland, there are two parts in adrenal gland. Cortex parts will release different glucocorticoids, mineralocorticoids and sex steroids. And medulla will release adrenaline and noradrenaline. And gonads will release different hormones like androgens, which is also known as testosterone, estrogen or estradiol, and progestin or progesterone. So these are the different glands and its hormones released in the body. And the specific knowledge of each hormone and its gland is very important, because according to that only we have to decide which hormone deficiency is there and how can we treat this hormonal deficiency, etc. So these are the different locations of endocrine system or endocrine gland. So there is one gland, hypothalamus, which will regulate all the hormones in the body through stimulating different hormones through the pituitary gland. And there is a pineal gland, which are present in the head, especially in the brain. And there is a thyroid and parathyroid gland in the area of neck. And then a thymus gland, then pancreas, which will release glucagon as well as insulin, then adrenal gland, which will release mineralocorticoids and corticosteroids, and the ovary, gonads will release different estrogen and progesterones. Then placenta also will release some estrogen and progesterone, and testicles in male will release testosterone. So these are the different site or location of different endocrine glands. Now, what is the function of hormone? So as we mentioned before, they will regulate the body function to bring about a programmed pattern of life even and maintain the hemostasis. So these are the some body function, and these are some hormones which are regulating this body functions. First one is availability of fuel. So this fuel or energy is synthesized from especially glucose and etc. So glucose balance will be maintained by different hormones like insulin, glucagon, and overall growth will be enhanced by the growth hormone. So these are the hormones which will regulate the availability of fuel. Second one is metabolic rate. Body metabolism is controlled by triiodothyronin and thyroxine, which are thyroid hormones secreted by thyroid gland. Then somatic growth, like growth hormone and insulin like growth factor. So that will help for the somatic growth of the body. Then sex and reproduction will be regulated by different hormones like gonadotropin, androgen, then estrogen and progesterone. Then circulating volume, body fluid will be regulated through the aldosterone as well as antidiuretic hormone. Then different adaptation to the stress condition is regulated by glucocorticoids as well as adrenaline, and calcium balance in the body is regulated by parathormone, calcitonin and vitamin D. So these are the different functions of different hormones in body in general. In next videos, we will discuss the specific pharmacology of each hormone in detail. Now coming to the regulation of release of hormone in general. So the release of hormone is ultimately regulated by hypothalamus. So if there is any deficiency or if there is an excess of release of any hormone, the corresponding releasing hormone in case of deficiency, inhibitory hormone in case of excess of hormone release will be secreted by hypothalamus. And by the action of this releasing as well as inhibitory hormone, anterior pituitary will stimulate the specific stimulating hormone from the anterior pituitary, which will stimulate the specific targeted gland. So this targeted gland will stimulate the secretion of hormone in case of deficiency, or they will prevent the secretion of hormone in cases of excess hormone cases. So that is the general regulation of an release. So we can explain this regulation with an example of adrenal glands like glucocorticoids and mineralocorticoids. So if the body is deficient of glucocorticoids or mineralocorticoids, hypothalamus will stimulate it, and this will release an hormone, releasing hormone, which is known as corticotropin releasing hormone. So by the action of this corticotropin releasing hormone, this will stimulate the anterior pituitary to stimulate the ACTH or adrenocorticotropic hormone. And this adrenocorticotropic hormone released from the anterior pituitary will stimulate the adrenal gland to release glucocorticoids and mineralocorticoids in cases of deficiency of glucocorticoids and mineralocorticoids. So now if our body have excess of glucocorticoids or mineralocorticoid secretion, this will negatively inhibit the hypothalamus, so that it will prevent the release of CRF or corticotropin releasing hormone. So there will not be any releasing of ACTH from anterior pituitary. So it will stop production of glucocorticoids and mineralocorticoids from adrenal gland. So this is the basic mechanism of regulation of different hormonal secretions, and it may vary with the different glands. This is an example in case of adrenal gland. So hope it is clear. This is the regulation of secretion. Now coming to the different hypothalamic hormone, as I mentioned before, the ultimate hormonal release will be regulated by the hypothalamus. So these are the different hypothalamic hormone which will stimulate the release from the pituitary gland. So this is thyrotropin releasing hormone, which is known as TRH, and by releasing this thyrotropin releasing hormone, this hypothalamus will stimulate the pituitary gland to stimulate the thyroid stimulating hormone. So TRH released from the hypothalamus will stimulate pituitary gland to produce TSH. So by the action of this TSH, it will stimulate the thyroid gland to produce thyroid hormone. So that is the basic regulation of release. Now coming to second hypothalamic hormone, that is corticotropic releasing hormone or CRH, and by the action of the CRH released from the hypothalamus, it will stimulate the pituitary gland to stimulate ACTH, and this will stimulate the adrenal gland to stimulate the adrenal glands. Now adrenal hormones. Now coming to the gonadotropin releasing hormone or GnRH, or LHRH, or FSHRH, or it is also known as gonadorelins. So these are the hormones released from the hypothalamus. So by the release of this hormone from hypothalamus, it will stimulate the pituitary gland to stimulate gonadotropins like FSH and LH. So by the action of FSH and LH, it will stimulate different gonad to produce estrogen, progesterone, as well as testosterone. Now coming to next hypothalamic hormone, that is the prolactin release inhibiting hormone. So by the action of this inhibitory hormone, release inhibitory hormone, this will inhibit the pituitary gland for the release of and thereby it will inhibit the prolactin release. Now coming to another hypothalamic hormone released from the hypothalamus, that is growth hormone release hormone, that is GHRH. By the action of GHRH release from the hypothalamus, it will stimulate the pituitary gland to stimulate the growth hormone release. Now another hypothalamic hormone is somatostatin or growth hormone release inhibitory hormone. So by the action of release of the somatostatin from the hypothalamus, it will inhibit the pituitary gland and thereby it will inhibit the growth hormone release. So these are the different hypothalamic or hormones for the regulation of hormonal release. Now coming to the mechanism of actions of hormones in general, hormones will act through their specific receptor located in the within the target cells, so thereby activate different hormones. So it may be act by three mechanism. Hormone may act at the receptor which are present in the cell membrane. So it may act through different mechanism, like by increasing cyclic AMP concentration in case of adrenaline, glucagon, TSH, FSH, PTH, etc. Or it may activate the membrane receptor through IPH, IP3 DAG generation like vasopressin and oxytocin. Or it may act at the membrane receptor by direct transmembrane activation of tyrosine protein kinase in case of insulin, growth hormone and prolactin. And second mechanism of hormone is acting at the cytoplasmic receptor. So in this, hormone will penetrate to the cell membrane and hormone will combine with the cytoplasmic receptor, and they will stimulate the hormone release effect of hormone like glucocorticoid, mineralocorticoid, androgen, estrogen, progesterone and calcitriol. And it may act through nuclear receptor. Hormone may penetrate to the nucleus and combine with the receptor and alter the RNA DNA mediated protein synthesis in case of tyrosine and triiodothyronine. So that is all about an introduction about the hormone. In further videos, we will discuss the pharmacology of hormones which are secreted from the different glands in detail. Hope it is clear. Thank you for watching this video.